In this video, I'd like to show how to calculate the standard deviation using a table. Standard deviation is one of measurements which describe the spread of a data set. Simply, it is the square root of the variance, so the formula is as shown. Xi stands for each observation, and x bar stands for the mean. Mean is calculated by another formula as shown. The last variable n, which stands for the sample size or the number of observations. Let's take a look at the example. First step, calculate the mean. First, add all observation values and dividing the sum by the number of observations, which is 8 patients, to get the mean as 205 mg per deciliter. Second step, making a table to find the sum of the squared deviations. For the first column, place all observation values. Next column, calculate the deviation from the mean for each observation. Lastly, calculate the squared deviations in the last column. For the first observation, 154, 154 minus 205 to get the negative 51 deviation from the mean. Keep this value on your calculator, then press the square key to get the squared deviation as 2601. For 234, 234 minus 205 to get the 29. As soon as we get 29, square it to get the square root deviation of 841. Repeat the same process all the way to the last observation, 262. Make sure to get 0 at the total in the second column. Get the sum of the last column as 8998. As the last step, we substitute the values into the formulas. The first formula for the variance is shown. It looks complicated, but we already found the numerator value of 8998. So we just divide that value by n minus 1 to get the variance. Since the number of observations is 8, 8998 divided by 7 to get 1285 for the variance. Then we get the standard deviation by taking the square root of the variance. Therefore, the standard deviation is the square root of the variance of 1285 to get 35.8 mg per deciliter. Please note that the unit of the standard deviation is the same as that of the mean. When you calculate the standard deviation, make sure to use the mean. Once you find the sum of the squared deviations, you already have the numerator value of the formula. To find the number of observations, you just count the number of x values. Thank you for watching. See you next time.